right, so I'm going to show you how to use blogs or set up a blog or a blog page or a blog post. All you need to do, like always, we're going to go ahead and go under our site that we always go to and click on View Details. And we're going to come over here where it says Blog Post. Now, you can create either customize your blog post by clicking on the blog post here, or, so we already have four blog posts that are already made, or you can come up here where it says Create, and then you would click Post. And that would also go bring you to the page of creating a new blog post. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and come down here, and we've already got these four created, and there's not too much difference between a post and a page when it comes to creating it. The difference is, again, the post, or the a page is a static page, where a post or a blog post is going to be for blogging specifically. And so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to create a blog post by clicking on this button here. Now what happens is when it comes to blogging, there's a couple of key things. You need to decide if you're going to be blogging, and if you're going to be blogging, the key to blogging is that it is going to be done consistently. Blogging is not something that you're going to want to do every single week for a week and then stop for 4 months and then go back and do it for 1 week and then stop and then do it every 6 months. You want to make sure that whatever you start with, try to be consistent on it. So if it's going to be once a month, if it's going to be once a quarter, if it's going to be once a week, if it's going to be twice a month, whatever that is, it doesn't matter. Obviously, the more content that's out there, the better for you to be found that way. But at the same time, whatever it is, you need to make sure that you do it consistently. That's really the key. So if you can't commit to doing something consistently, you probably don't need to do the blogging. But blogging is a great way to be able to pick up traffic. A couple of other key things when it comes to blogging. You're going to want to make sure that your blog posts are between or at least 500 to 700 words per post at the very least. So the more words, the better. The other thing too is you're also going to want to make sure you have very good descriptive keywords that are going to pertain. So if you're going to be writing about certain things like short sales, you're going to be writing about great neighborhoods or dog parks or whatever, you're going to want to make sure that you're using those proper keywords so people, when they're searching online, that they can come across your page and that the title matches the content that's on it. All right, so that being said, we're going to come over here and we're going to scroll on down, and we've got a post right here, and I'm going to go ahead and create a little quick post that's going to be kind of cool. All right, so my title is Training Makes You More Money at Keller Williams. And I'm going to write a little blog that's going to talk a little bit about the people who go to classes and how much money they make versus the people that don't go to classes and how much they make. It's a really cool idea that I'm not going to write a whole bunch of content right now, but you'll get the idea of what it will look like, and then we'll kind of go from there. Let me write a little bit of content real quick. All right, so from here, what I've got now is I wrote this little article here. It's a little dinky thing. Definitely not enough words, but it's got a little start, and it'll cover everything that I need to. Now, what I want to do is I want to add a couple pictures. I want to add a picture of our calendar. That's one of the things I want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and put a little space there, and that's where I'm going to put the calendar. So I'm going to scroll on back up and see where it says right here, Upload Image. All we need to do is click on Upload Image, and I'm going to go ahead and choose the file. And the file that I'm going to be uploading, and we pick the calendar, put open, and we'll scroll on down. You'll be able to see that the calendar's right there. Perfect. So we got one image in there. The second image, I'm going to go ahead and put it in the middle. I want you to kind of see how that works. Is we're going to go ahead and put this right here, and we're going to put another upload image, and we're going to choose the file. And the second image I'm going to put in there, this is a little image for showing how we're tracking things. Now there's a couple things I want to do. I want to click on this button here, or click on the image right here. What I want to do is click on it, and then I want to make this one a little bit smaller. I want to make it so it's not as big, and I want to click on this. Then I want to move this back a little bit and see what that looks like. Click edit here. And see where it says position? I want to have the position all the way to the left, which means I'm going to have some words along the right. See that? Perfect. Now, you'll be able to see there's a little ways. I made this. This is saying, where do you want this picture to be? Do I want to have it to the left, or do I want to have it to the right? So I can click edit and say, hey, I want to move this to the right. And you'll see the picture goes on that side. Or I could say I want it in the center. And you'll see how that goes. But I want to put it on the left. We'll click save. Now all we need to do is from here, we're going to scroll on down here. There's a featured image file. And I could actually go ahead and click on choose file. And I'm going to go ahead and use this calendar as our feature image file. And we're going to use that as kind of our main image. And so we've got a couple images in there. And we'll see how that looks. I don't know exactly how this is going to look, but it'll be exciting to see all this stuff. And then down here at the bottom, the meta title and meta description. So I'm going to go ahead and copy the same title that I used here. And I'm going to put this down at the bottom. Remember, this needs to be keyword sensitive, and we want to make sure we're using proper keywords. And again, it has to be 155 characters for the description and 55 characters for the meta title. Remember, the meta title and the meta description, the blue parts, that's the meta title, and this gray part here is the description. So we want to make sure that we use the proper meta title and meta description. So on this one, perfect. I use keyword Keller Williams, the marketplace in Henderson, Nevada, gets results with its real estate agent training. So I can get a little bit better if I wanted to. Now, just let you guys know, I can go ahead and click where it says Save as Draft. When I click Save as Draft, I saved it. You'll see that this right here, the post, is currently not live on the internet. So I can come up here where it says View Live Site. And you'll scroll on down to where the blog section is and see where it says Dealing with Financing. That is not my most recent post. What my most recent post is my one that it's a draft. So if I want to go ahead and make this live, all I need to do is just go ahead and click Edit. Scroll down to the bottom. Click Save. And then that post, when I go ahead and refresh it, there it is. Training makes you more money at Keller Williams. So I can go ahead and it shows the date that I posted it. I can click on it. That's the main picture at the top, a little bit overkill. Might be too much, so we might need to remove that if you think. There's my screenshot of my training that I wanted to put in there, and there's our training for our calendar. So it's got all my stuff in there. So that's how you're able to kind of write a blog post. Okay? And then what happens is when it comes to your blog posts, you'll be able to find them all on home, and each one of the themes has a different place for the blog, and these are all the blog posts right here. So that is how you are able to make a blog post.